First of all, let's go and download the Proxmox ISO from the website. You need to go proxmox.com. Then we'll go to downloads. And in the download section, you will see by the time of this recording, 7.2 is the latest one. So we'll be downloading the ISO by clicking here. Or maybe you can download it from student website also, your choice. Once the download is completed, by using Rufus, we will burn the ISO image into our pen drive. So our pen drive will be a bootable device. My pen drive is already selected here, and we will select the ISO downloaded 1.2, and we will leave all of this as is, and we'll click on start. And we need to select DD image mode. Although it is recommended, but we will use DD image mode for this purpose. Now it will start it. Once this is complete, I'll get back to you. It's completed now. Let's go. Let's insert the pen drive here and turn on the laptop right now. And we need to open the boot menu, BIOS settings. By pressing escape or function keys as per your as per your laptop or PC manufacturer settings. Usually it will be an escape key to get into this menu. From there we will go to BIOS settings, F10, and we will go into configuration and boot options. So once we are here, we need to make sure that we are booting from USB device first. Usually most of the times it will be on a OS boot menu in the top like this, so we need to make sure that we use this one USB on top, so that whenever we plug in the USB it will boot from us first. If USB is not there, then it will be booting from our hard disk. And once we configure like this, then we can save and exit F10, so it will save and exit. From there it will boot from our USB drive. Okay, the highlighted one install Proxmox VE, so we'll click on enter. Here the user license, and click on agree in the right hand corner. Once again we will select here. I have two hard disks right now, but I will use this one. Then click next. And we will specify our details. Right now I'm in India and Asia Kolkata is it. And click next. And now we will add our passport for the root user. And we will give a valid email address here. And then click next. The management interface, I have only one network. If you have multiple network cards, you can select whichever you want. Then we'll use IP address. For me, I'll use 107 as my IP address for this laptop, I mean for this machine. And DNS I'll use same. I don't actually, you can now change this to DNS like 8.8.8.8 or 1.1.1.1 and click next. Here are the details for the automatically reboot after installation. Okay, nice, continue. But I forgot to tell you that you need to have a LAN cable for this. You need to use LAN because Proxmox won't allow you to use for your Wi-Fi. It only works on a LAN. That's it. Our system is ready. So right now I'll be plugging it to the LAN port now, and we'll get back to from the browser using this URL. Now our PC was connected to the LAN. Now let's connect to it through HTTPS. HTTPS or IP of the laptop 0.107. Remember the port 8006. We'll go advance and proceed. Now the default user is root. And did you remember the password we set earlier? The same password while installing the OS. Don't panic, just okay, click okay. And now we are connected to the PC. So these are our storages. This is a disk image and containers, and this is for our storage in the ISO files, backup files and container templates and etc. So let's first add our ISO files. Okay, we can upload or download whatever. Now let's select this file. We already have our files here, so I'll be selecting this one. Click upload. You can also directly download from the website to this one also. I will show you in a bit. So it is finished now. So here you can see task OK. So it is completed. I already told you how you can also download from this. Here you can just paste the download URL and it will start downloading. Okay. And now we'll spin up a VM using this ISO file. Okay. Let's create VM and we'll give a name for this. This version is Ubuntu 22.04 LTS version, so I'll give this name as a name, and then sorry, it did not take spaces, so I'll just leave it as Ubuntu. Click next, and then we will select the image here. Click next. From there, we'll just leave as is. This is all the settings for BIOS and etc. So we'll leave, and this is the space we will queue our disk space for the VM. Let's say it is asking for 32, you can also give 40, 50, whatever your storage have, whatever you wish to give. I'll just leave it to 30 because I will destroy this after this completed. No problem. So 50 also, whatever you want, like say. And we'll give how many cores of CPU you can give. Right now I have 4 cores, so I'll use 2 cores and click next. And now it will give 4 GB of space, and I mean 4 GB of RAM, and click on next. And this is for the network, and we'll just leave as is, and no problem for that. And after that, we want to start the process. You can manually start from after that, but I'll click here. Once it is finished, then it will start the VM automatically. You can see here. And that it is getting ready to start up. You can see it is starting up now here, as we mentioned here, while setting up the VM, 2 cores, 4 GB of RAM and 550 GB of storage. Okay, we'll go to console and now install. I'll just quickly go through the setup process. Finally complete. Now restart now. Can see we are using Ubuntu on a browser. Okay, let's close. Before we close this up, I want you to, if you are using this on a laptop, you might want to consider following this change. Let's go to PBE shell and then nano plus etc plus systemd plus login d.conf. In this we want to handle lit switch to ignore, and also the handle lit switch docked also to ignore. Okay, and save this one, control X, Y, and press enter. What this will do is, if you close the lid, it will stay awake, it will ignore this one. Okay, and now we want to put our screen to sleep. How can we do that? You also need to go to another file called, it is located in etc. default and then grub. In this we want to go to the, we need to go to this line, it says grub command line linux, and we need to place the following command, which is console blank equals to 300. Here 300 means 300 seconds. After that, the console will go blank. Okay, we'll simply save and exit. After that, we need to update our grub. We need to type update grub. We also need to restart the systemd login service also. Systemctl restart systemd login d service. It's now complete. I just close the lid now. Let's see if this is working or not. and now it's working. I just closed my lid, the laptop right now. Hope you learned something new. Bye. Take care.